can gilteritinib cure AML?
The ADMIRAL trial showed an improvement in the median survival of patients treated with gilteritinib from about 5 to 6 months to 9 months. Now, very few patients were still receiving gilteritinib after 2 years, and that shouldn't be unexpected since FLT3 mutations, especially the ITV mutation, is a late event in leukemogenesis. So I think it would be unlikely that a single agent such as gilteritinib would be effective as a more prolonged maintenance therapy in patients. I think it's highly unlikely that any FLT3 inhibitor as a single agent would be curative for acute myeloid leukemia. As we know, this is a very heterogeneous disease. The median number of mutations in patients is 4, and FLT3 mutations, especially the ITD, are late events in leukemogenesis. So by just targeting FLT3 with an inhibitor, I think it's highly unlikely that we'll get prolonged remissions with single agent therapy. And so we really do need to stress and focus on combinations with chemotherapies, either intensive, such as 7+3 and high-dose cytarabine, or less intensive therapies in order to see a benefit of FLT3 inhibition, or in the future, immunotherapies as well in combination with FLT3 inhibitors such as gilteritinib.
Can a patient develop resistance to gilteritinib?
Resistance can occur with any FLT3 inhibitor that we use in the clinic. In terms of gilteritinib, we do see resistance develop. Now, since gilteritinib is a type 1 inhibitor and it inhibits both the FLT3 ITD and the TKD mutation, when patients progress on gilteritinib, they typically do not have a FLT3 ITD or TKD mutation. However, other mutations develop, and the most commonly identified mutation in those patients are mutations in RAS.
Thanks for watching. By creating a HealthTree account, you can get exclusive access to the latest HealthTree University content, track your course progress, take notes, and bookmark lessons. Visit the links in the description below to get started.